Hello friends, my name is Alok Kumar, an educator at an academy. So friends, if you have an idea that you want to transform into reality, then please follow me on an academy learning app where you'll find my other courses around digital marketing and entrepreneurship. Please rate, review and share my courses, and please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And this particular lesson is about the tips or the skills required to be a successful English writer in business. So let's get started. So participants, as I have discussed right now that, you know, this particular lesson is about the skills required to be a high paying content writer or a very successful English writer. Actually, the part one of it. So the very first thing that you should inculcate as a skill is to be a successful English writer is to focus on your reader. You have to step into the shoes of your reader first of all. You have to understand the pain points of your reader so that your content can actually address those pain points. Now see, somebody when comes to a write-up, start reading, he or she comes with a question. You have to ensure as a writer that your write-up or your article or your case study or your blog should have the capacity to solve those questions. And it is only possible when you focus on your reader only. Remember the concept of reader's persona in my previous lessons. You have to understand your reader very well. Some of the great writers understand their readers better than their family members. Right. So the very first thumb rule or the very first skill that is required to be a great, to be a high paying, to be a successful English writer is to have a great focus on your reader. The second tip is that, you know, having in-depth understanding about your topic. You can be a successful writer when you have the caliber to cook great words. Cook unique words with every next article. Your next article should create that kind of thought leadership effect. Your each explanation should add value to the readership. Remember, you know, an in-depth understanding will help you to create great informative and relevant write-ups, which is very much necessary in business. Now see, the business space today online is very competitive. If you want your business or if you want your client to stand out in the competition or if you want your business's message to cut through the noise and reach to the right prospect, then you have to ensure that the content should be very, very unique. And it is only possible when you gain a strong understanding. It is only possible when you read a lot, when you have that researching attitude, right? Never ever hesitate to research about a topic that you think that can pay you really, make you really great money. Okay, so having in-depth understanding about your topic. So let's say, for example, if you want to write about travel and tourism, you know, infuse yourself into that particular niche. Read as much as you can, explore as much as you can, travel as much as you can, talk to travel bloggers as much as you can. Okay, the third most important is that you need to have unmatched proofreading and editing capacity. As a writer, you have to understand that you should create very high quality content, and it is only possible when you have the proofreading and editing capacity. Your content, your write-up should be grammatically 200% correct. The flow should talk to the prospect directly. The element of storytelling should be in your write-up. Your content should have a very strong introduction and a very appealing conclusion. So participants, a very strong proofreading and editing capacity can actually help you to
refine your content and create a great product at the end. When I'm talking product, it means that, you know, a great book or a great write-up, right? The next tip is being original. Now see, original genuineness always pays off. Always remember, you know, when you have something original to tell, it will definitely grab eyeballs. You just cannot persist, sustain in the market just by replicating others or, you know, creating duplicate content. You have to be original. You know, if you keep on talking about the same things that everyone is talking about in the market, then definitely, you know, it's not English writing. It is called as English content curation, right? So participants, now let me tell you, be original, give time to your niche, give time to your subject, do in-depth research and come up with some original piece. Impeccable storytelling skills. Storytelling is a must in content writing. Okay, you should have the art of storytelling in your English writing for business. Storytelling is an art. Just stay tuned. In my coming lessons, you will find a specific lesson about storytelling in English writing for business, right? Storytelling is nothing but creating substantial elements, creating substantial characters, creating a dramatic move in your writing so that it keeps your readers engaged in your content. And the last but not the least, art to focus on loyal and regular readers. Now see, senior writers, you know, successful writers, they do not actually write for money. They write for creating a subscriber base. They write to create a regular reader base. When you have regular readers on your blog, when you have a big subscriber base, when you have a big list, you know, money becomes the byproduct, right? So you have to focus on creating a loyal and regular readers. Okay, you have to think from the reader's perspective. Never focus on money, right? Money will be the byproduct, let me tell you. Okay, just focus on creating a big list of regular readers. So participants, I believe that you enjoyed the lesson. Just stay tuned. I'll be soon coming up with the part 2 of this particular lesson. So if you have any questions or queries, then please put down your comments below the course. I'll be happy to help you out. So if you think that I have missed on something that you'd like to share with our other learners, then please comment below. I would love to hear your comments. So this is Alok Kumar signing out for now. Have a nice day. Bye-bye. Thanks a lot.